everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Anmol. I'm a doctor based in India, currently doing my residency in dermatology, and this is a vlog about a day in the life of a dermatology resident in India. So let's jump straight to the fun part. So my day starts at 6:30 a.m. and I have to get to work by around 8:30 a.m. So I have about 2 solid hours for my morning routine. Of course, in the first year of residency, you have to get to work about an hour earlier to finish all the ward work, which includes taking blood collection samples of patients, measuring their vitals and checking in on patients, etc. As I said previously in my other videos, we in our department have around 10 to 14 patients admitted at a time. So the ward work isn't really that much. But that said, in the first year of your residency, you might have to get to work a little earlier. So I used to come around 6:30 to 7 a.m. But now that I'm in my final year, I directly reach the OPD usually, which is around 8:30 a.m. Also, as a third year resident, whenever I'm on call, so during my on-call week, I have to reach earlier, that is around 7:30 a.m. in order to take the morning ward rounds. On-call basically means you're in charge of the admitted patients, the ward patients. So you have to take morning ward rounds, you have to take evening ward rounds, and you have to also attend to patients who need a dermatology consults who are admitted in the other wards of the hospital. So that's what on-call means. So there are 6 residents in my batch. So I'm usually on call around once every 6 weeks. So I'm gonna go to work now. It's a 5-minute ride and I'll see you there. My day at work starts at the OPD, the outpatient department. On an average, we have around 250 to 300 patients per day. So I get to see at least 25 patients a day. So I'm in the OPD from 8:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. around, sometimes if it's heavier, then around 1 p.m. Patient after patient, and time just flies by. My tools in the OPD are my hand sanitizer, of course. Then my tab, on which I can quickly look up and read a research article for any latest treatment guidelines and options that I want to look up, or just quickly read up on any doubts I may be having. My hand lens, which is a must for any dermatologist. It's a handy equipment which is a magnifying glass with a light source attached to it to have a clear and magnified view of the skin lesions. Then my dermoscope, which is a very important diagnostic tool in Dermat. It's a small device that can be connected to your laptop via a USB cable, and you can just put it over the affected skin and see patterns that help you identify skin disorders. So it's pretty cool. You can see a magnified view of the skin lesions here on the screen.
This is just a small drawer where I keep samples of medicines for patients who sometimes can't afford to buy expensive medication, and also for snacking if I get hungry in between. So we're currently in the female examination room. This is the female examination room, and this is an instrument also known as the Woods lamp. It's again used to make it's a diagnostic tool in dermatology. It has a UV light source attached to it, and we sometimes examine lesions in the dark using the Woods lamp to diagnose certain hypopigmented disorders. And right opposite the female examination room is the male examination room. So that's the male examination room, and right next to it is the minor OT. So now we're going to go into the minor OT. So now we're entering the minor OT, where we perform dermatological surgeries like vitiligo surgery, cyst excision, earlobe repair, lipoma excision, etc.
We usually post surgeries before or after the OPD hours. So I usually like to schedule them on Tuesdays and Saturdays when our OPD load is the least heavy. So before or after the OPD, we post these procedures, and all of these surgeries, most of the surgeries in dermat take only about 1 to 2 hours. So it's not that long.
This is the centrifuge machine, which is used to centrifuge the blood samples for procedures like PRP, platelet-rich plasma, IPRF and PRF.
These procedures are useful in a variety of skin disorders like hair fall treatment, scar treatment, leg ulcer treatment. So PRP is a very common modality which is used for treatment of hair fall. And PRF, platelet-rich fibrin, is a very common thing that we use in treatment of leg ulcers. It magically heals the leg ulcers. So in these procedures, you need to centrifuge the patient's blood in order to extract the supernatant therapeutic plasma from it. So that's what this is used for.
Next, we are going to the UV therapy and the laser room, where all the machines for phototherapy and the lasers are installed. So here we don't do the work, the machines do the work. This is a UVB chamber for phototherapy, and this is a UVA chamber. So this is where the patient just goes inside the chamber and stands. It's used for treatment of vitiligo, psoriasis, mycosis fungoids. So these are the phototherapy machines. And inside we have the lasers installed. So this right here, the red one, is a Q-switch laser, which is used for tattoo removal, lip lightening, and removal of certain birthmarks, etc. And here we have the IPL machine. IPL is intense pulse light. So it is not exactly a laser, but it is again a broad spectrum light therapy, which is used for treatment of, hair removal, etc. And this is a photo testing machine, which is used for diagnosis of certain photodermatosis. So here we have the laser room. And this is the biopsy room, where we mainly do skin biopsies and other minor procedures like comedone extraction, molluscum extraction, parring, etc. Then we have the special OPD clinics, where we are posted turn by turn. So we have seven special clinics each day of the week, Monday to Saturday, during the OPD hours, where we are posted monthly, turn by turn. Currently, I'm in the pediatric dermatology OPD, so I just sit here on Thursdays and we have fun with the cute babies. This is another procedure room. This is the room where we do chemical peels. It's a 5 to 10 minute procedure with some pretty great results for acne and pigmentation, and it's one of my favorite parts of dermatology. And this is the electrocautery and radio frequency ablation machine, which is used for DPN and skin tag removal, wart removal, etc.
So you get the idea, there's a lot to do here during as well as after the OPD. So I'm usually here in the OPD around till around 2 p.m. after which is my lunchtime. So after the OPD, I have around 20 to 25 minutes to get some lunch, get something to eat, and sort of re-energize and rejuvenate for the academic session that we have post-lunch. So usually after lunch, I like to come back to the department and view some dermatopathology slides. fun part is that in our institute we have an excellent dermatopathology section. So we perform biopsies ourselves, and whatever biopsies we perform, we get to report them ourselves as well. So it's pretty exciting. So you see a patient, think of a diagnosis, do the dermoscopy and see what the dermoscopy shows, do the biopsy yourself, see what the biopsy shows for yourself, and come to a final diagnosis all inside of the department. So I find it a very nice and a very holistic way of learning.
We have a dermpath room with a microscope that's connected to a TV. So viewing slides is super easy and fun, and you get to learn so much. There's also a little section where we can make smears like AFB stain, Gram stain and Zank smears, which are sometimes used for diagnosis. So there's like a mini pathology and a mini microbiology section within the department. So the whole experience is pretty holistic.
So from 2:30 to 4 p.m. we have academic sessions in our department where all the residents and faculties in the department come and sit together in the seminar room. And there are lectures, case presentations, interesting case discussions, histopathology sessions. So it's a very interactive learning session. Medicine is an ever-evolving science and physicians never stop learning. So it's kind of a way to learn new things every day, keep up with the latest researches and recent advances that are going on, and also sort of brush up your old theory knowledge. After 4 p.m., if you're not on call, you can officially leave the hospital campus. So that's the end of the workday. Once I get back home at around 4, I usually take a short nap. After which, when I get up, I study for around 2 hours. In the evenings, I make dinner. Sometimes I practice music because I love to sing. Then sometimes I just like to sit and read for a while, catch up on my dissertation-related work, work on any research paper if it's due. Then rest of the days I try to create meaningful content for you guys, and then some days I just, you know, do whatever I want, try to recreate, because especially in our profession it's very important to actively recreate and not stress too much over things. Usually I call it a day at around 12 a.m. and go to bed. So that's it guys, I hope you enjoyed your exclusive look in a day in the life of a dermatology final year resident, and I hope you now have a taste of what it's like. If you like this video and want more, please feel free to like and subscribe or drop a hi in the comments below. Also, for more similar content, you can follow me on Instagram as well. You can connect with me on Instagram anytime. I'm always happy to hear from you. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.